गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास स्टैंडर्ड 6 लेसन 1 मैग्नेटिज्म. इन आवर लास्ट लेसन लास्ट क्लास वी विल स्टॉप इन द मैग्नेटिक कॉम्पस. नाउ वी सी द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैग्नेट्स. द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैग्नेट्स आर टू. वन इज अट्रैक्शन और रिपल्शन. ओके, टेक two similar magnet, place them in four different ways as shown in figure. Yes, the south and north or north and south pole are attract to each other. The opposite direction is attract to each other. The similar magnet like north and north, south and south, they are not attract, they are repulsion. It is called a repulsion. These are the properties of magnet. North pole and south pole, or south pole and north pole, are attract to each other. North and north pole, south and south pole are repulsion. Okay, this is the properties of magnet, children. Unlike poles, south pole, north pole, north pole and south pole attract each other. The like poles, north and north, south and south, repel each other. Next, do magnet lose their properties when? Yes, the magnets are also lost their properties. Because what are the properties? Magnets lost their properties if they are heated or dropped from a height or hit with a hammer. One is when heated, you heat the magnet, the magnet power will be lost. Then when dropped, the magnet is also called the power will be, the magnetic power will be lost. The third one, when hammered the magnet, the attraction power will be lost. Okay, these are the magnets to lose their properties. Next one, storage of magnets. How will storage the magnets? Improper storage can also cause magnets to lose their properties. Improper storage. Okay, keep them safe, bar magnet should be kept in pair with their unlike poles on the same side. They must be separated by a piece of wood, and two pieces of soft iron should be placed across their ends. This is the way to storage the magnets. Okay, this is the bar magnet. The bar magnets are stored in a wooden pieces. Okay, next, for a horseshoe magnet, a single piece of soft iron can be used as a magnet keeper across the poles. Next, usage of magnets. The magnets are used in many ways. For example, speakers, in electric motors, in some door locks, bags, some toys, compass, pencil box, stickers on refrigerator, phone covers, pin holder, magnetic crane. These are the magnets are used. Okay, next, science today in bullet train. This is the experiment, levitating propeller. Do the exercise in our home, children. Okay, next one, the last one is Mangalore train. This train is introduced in China, Japan and South Korea. Okay, the train has not creating a heavy sound and pollution is less. The sound also less. Okay, how does the electromagnetic train work? The electromagnets are used in electromagnetic train. Electromagnets are magnetized only when current flows through them. When the direction of current is changed, the poles of the electromagnetic are also changed. Like poles of the magnet, which are attached to the bottom of the train and rail track, ripple each other. So the train is lifted from the track up to the height of 10 centimeter. We know that we can move any magnetic object with the force of attraction or repulsion properties of magnets. This train also moves with the help of magnets attached on the side of the track and the magnets fitted at the bottom sideway of the train. The magnet is fixed in the track and also in the bottom of the train. By controlling the current, we can control magnets or movement of the train. As there are no moving parts, there is no friction, so the train can easily attain a speed of 300 km per hour. These trains are capable of running up to 600 km per hour. They do not make any noise, they require less energy, and they are eco-friendly. Even though many countries have taken effort to use these trains, such trains are used to public transport only in China, Japan and South Korea. In India, the possibilities of introducing these trains are under consideration. Okay, now that lesson is over, children. Next points to remember. Magnetites are natural magnets. They are called magnetic stones. Man-made magnets are called artificial magnets. Substances which are attracted by magnet are called magnetic substances. Substances which are not attracted by magnetic are called non-magnetic substances. A freely suspended magnet always comes to rest in north-south direction. The end of the magnet that points to the north is called the north pole. The end at that points to the south is called the south pole. A compass is an instrument which is used to find directions. Like poles, north and north, south and south ripple each other. And unlike poles, north, south, south, north attract each other. Magnets lose their properties if they are heated or dropped from a height or hit with a hammer. Okay, now the lesson is over, children. In our next class, we see the evaluation. Okay, now next class, we see the evaluation. Okay, children.
Thank you.